Hello, good day. So I will be watching and commenting on the E3 2012 from Nintendo, and this was the last one that I did live. And this was very special because I remember being very hyped for the Wii U at the time, just by watching this E3. So let's see the levels of audio here. I was just getting into Pikmin at the time, and just looking at this was incredible, so I will just speed it up a little bit, because there is a lot to talk about, and this is a 1 hour and 10 minute thing. Thank you. Oh no, they're actually cheering for Miyamoto. No, I'm joking. Hello. Okay, I'm going to speed this up a little bit because I like how he calls Bill training here.
I'd like to ask Bill's help in allowing me to speak in Japanese.
Please call him.
Obey the captain.
Okay, so we see the Wii U in its final state there, and that is very beautiful.
It has already been 6 years since we launched Wii, hasn't it?
Although it is shown with just the Wii U logo on the screen, and it looks excellent, it looks beautiful. And here is the next Pikmin. This was in 2012, and the game released in 2016. The shocking thing is that it's almost 10 years since this game. It was relaunched for the Switch. But the fourth Pikmin was announced in 2015 or something, and the project, we haven't heard anything else from the project.
If it's too far away, you can't see the Pikmin, and if it's too close, you can't see the full map. The enhanced resolution of the Wii U has solved this puzzle for us.
This game looks beautiful.
Now you can see the tiny movements of each Pikmin, and you can see that the natural
It's weird how in the Switch and Wii U they changed the textures and everything for some reason. The game, of course, doesn't look like this in the Wii U or Switch, so for me this looks worse and better at the same time, and the Wii U and Switch versions differentiate from each other from being worse and better as well. Here we are introduced to the Rock Pikmin. So the thing is that they are playing the game with the Wiimote and Nunchuk, so that was the idea, and many people loved it like that. But I actually like to use the gamepad as to use the touch screen to play instead. And that's how it was done on Nintendo Land. So I was very hyped for Pikmin 3. Mr. Bean. So that gave me lots. That was very fun. So here we go. Reggie, who is not a Nintendo anymore.
I feel just like a purple Pikmin.
Okay, I'm going to
speed
this up.
Thank you, Mr. Miyamoto and Bill.
So here he talks about the Wii U and 3DS, how they can be shared, and to many more. And they explain the controller once again, which is very sad and unnecessary. But I still needed that, I think, because I had no idea about the microphone and all of that stuff. But this is the early Wara Wara Plaza, and I was, what is this? So let me pause a little bit. So we have Donkey Kong, Mario Kart, Boo. So we thought that it was Luigi's Mansion, Yoshi, and Star, so this could be Mario Party, Metroid, I already said, Zelda, a gun, and Wii Fit. So the thing is, that Donkey Kong was Tropical Freeze, Mario was 3D World, or New Super Mario Bros. U, Mario Kart 8, Luigi's Mansion never happened on the Wii U. The star was Mario Party 10, probably. Yoshi was probably Yoshi's Woolly World. Metroid never happened on the Wii U. Zelda was Wind Waker HD, Twilight Princess HD, and Breath of the Wild. And the gun was probably Zombi U. On that main street. They represent both your personal tastes also, there is the system here. That's trending globally on Wii U. Also, this TV screen looks very shitty, actually. They communicate. Looks very old. Each is equipped with a wide so range here of they showed New Super Mario Bros. U, and I love the colors here.
In New Super Mario Bros. U,
that looks
not only
beautiful.
Will you be able to see what
entire scenery
are
and
when the Miis gather,
I don't know.
Around
I really
the
like
Street,
the color blue, I think.
But also, be able to
but also
right within the game.
That was the first game I tried.
Friends, family,
in launch day, I went to a store. Just by coincidence, they had the Wii U. Well, probably not at launch day, but a few days later, because games arrived later here. And they let me try New Super Mario Bros. U, the first stage in the second world, and it was beautiful. I loved every minute of it. And the gamepad was so... what's the name? It was... It weighed little, very little. So it was very interesting to use. I never expected it to be so...
Here's New Super Mario Brothers U.
What is the word that I'm searching for? And here's the first look, and the game wasn't very interesting for many, but for me, I thought, wow, new tiles, those tiles look excellent. The backgrounds, the new backgrounds, the... That new enemy that's weird, and down there was sand, baby Yoshi that invades for some reason. So I liked how this game looked. I thought that it looked better than Zomero's Wii. And I also thought that the baby Yoshis were too powerful, and I was right. This stage looks excellent. Wow. It looks like that in the game,
as
and
you
I really
may
like that.
Know, this, Mario game
this stage also.
From the big screen,
I remember being very hyped, but then the final shot of this of the trailer looks very bad.
What we're calling boost mode.
Boost mode.
With up to four people
show
using
it.
Their
there
Wii
it is.
To race through
the
course. The
early boost mode.
With the gamepad,
because all blocks give you coins
to
right now.
Place blocks along the
this
way.
Looks absolutely bad.
Or you and a friend can work together to set a new standard for a speed run.
But boost mode was very
currently
good.
The benefits of
Batman.
We're going to spend some time
I was not very interested in the Batman games,
like
and I haven't played them. But I still think that the trailer, how they presented this, was pretty lame. But then they present how the game works, and I remember not caring much about Batman.
In addition, you will find the armored versions of both Batman and Catwoman fully playable
Batman.
And exclusive on the Wii U.
Batman. Sorry.
I hope you enjoy the presentation.
The game must be cool on Wii U, but I still don't have it. So they used a lot of time on Batman.
Now,
then they went with the Scribblenauts, and they show
Wayne
Mario,
Schneider,
I think, here.
From WB Games Montreal.
So that was weird, and here I will just show a little bit of Scribblenauts. So Scribblenauts Unlimited.
Your imagination.
This is Unlimited, right? Yeah. I almost bought this game, but I wasn't able to. And this game was available for Wii U, 3DS, and then it was released on PC. So this was kind of an exclusive, but it was a very cool game at the time. People really cared about Scribblenauts. And those games were on clearance later. So I got Scribblenauts DC and for very cheap. So this is Darksiders 2. The game runs very badly on Wii U. Well, not that bad, but it can get nauseating. But the game is pretty good, so I really recommend anyone to try this game. Just a quick thing. This is spoilers, right? That was from the first game. I have bought Darksiders. The Darksiders 2, I have it digitally. And Darksiders 1, I have it physically. And that was a really rare release. Really, really late and rare release. So Mass Effect 3 was the thing that people were like, oh no. So here you see, you hear the audience cheering. But Mass Effect 3 was released a few months after the trilogy collection was released on PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360. So this Wii U version was worthless, probably. Also, you didn't have Mass Effect 2 or on one and 1 on the Wii U. So you had the ending of this story, and this ending was underwhelming to some. So here we have Tank, a Namco arcade game, and people thought that this game was trash. And some think say that it is very cool, so that's Tekken. But this game used online, and people have said that it was very cool, but I actually never tried the game. I only got the free version. And here we have Tekken Tag Tournament 2, and this one, this is the game that I want to have. This was just recently delisted from the Wii U eShop. Here is Tank 2. I never understood why Nintendo did promote this game so much, because even though they use physics and whatnot, those games aren't trying. The Tank series is not a series that I like. That's what I'm trying to say. Ninja Gaiden 3 is, well, another game that I almost bought. And you can play with the touch screen, I think. So that was very cool. So, Aliens Colonial Marines was cancelled for the Wii U. There was a very big controversy about that. And that was all for the sizzle reel. So I was motivated for Darksiders 2. Probably Batman, I don't remember very well. But I already said that it wasn't that interesting.
Adventures featuring Batman and Mario may be eternal, but new forms of gaming emerge all the time.
It was an interesting presentation. I was more interested on on Metro last night, and that game didn't release for the Wii U, so that was very sad. So here we're talking about Wii Fit, and Wii Fit U is the best version of this series, so I really recommend this one. I have tried to buy it a lot more than all the games that I mentioned, and I haven't been able to. What is this? Oh no, this is the worst part of the presentation. Let me skip it a little bit so you can see it. This is what I call a no game, and this wasn't released anywhere else, only in America. So I don't understand what they were trying to do with this. Sync Party was the cringe of this presentation. Look at that character. Oh no. It was the worst part. So that probably killed the Wii U a little bit also. So here they talk about New Super Mario Bros. 2, which is something that also will kill the Wii U, because, well, the Wii U is dead, but imagine you are talking about a new Super Mario Bros. Game for the Wii U, and you also, oh, but you can get the 3DS one, even though the Wii U version is better. People were just happy with getting the 3DS version, so
in a year like this, when everyone will be going for
it,
the
was
gold,
very sad.
It's going to be hard to beat Mario. So I won't try to explain all the depth.
That was a reference to the Olympics at that year.
But I will during our 3DS event tomorrow. So I hope you'll all tune in then.
Okay, so we have Paper Mario Sticker Star
now,
here, which is
Paper Mario himself
something
is
that people are also pissed about. And
3D,
I played this game twice. I almost beat it twice, but the final boss is horrible. So I was kind of hyped at the time for this game, but actually,
Paper Mario world is plastered.
But I think that at the time, most of the games that they were talking here were already announced. Like Luigi's Mansion 2 was announced in the previous E3. and you saw Mario Bros. 2 in a Nintendo Direct. And here, what do we have here?
At some of the third party lineup.
Third party.
Thanks a lot, everybody.
Okay, thanks. So we have Castlevania Lords of Shadow, Mirror of Fate, the ones that did Metroid Dread and Samus Returns later. This game, I tried this, even though it seems like a return to classics or whatever, this game, the demo, was horrible. I remember really disliking it. And that was the brand of Epic Mickey. And here we have another Wii U game on 3DS. So people were like, yeah, why do I need a Wii U if I have the game on 3DS, right? Kingdom Hearts 3D. Wii U doesn't have Kingdom Hearts. We just need 3DS. So it's a tough selling, the Wii U. Wii U game had a Mario reference, I think, at that time. Including Need for Speed Most Wanted U. Here we have a liar called Ubisoft. Here we have Just Dance. I will skip Just Dance because I don't want copyright. I should have skipped Sing It, right? Well, it doesn't matter really. Here we have Zombi U. And Zombi U is... Wow, it's this game. One of those games that you see on clearance every day. Well, of course, this was not how it looked, how the game looks or played, or the animations were never like that, but the game is actually really neat because you need to keep an eye on both screens, and keeping an eye in one can actually fuck you in the other one. That's a great idea. Probably one of the best uses of the gamepad, and here we have Zombi Reggie. If you care for this,
but before this go,
they like French.
Let me leave you with this last video highlighting Ubisoft's lineup for the Wii U.
I'm hungry now.
You scare me, Reggie.
Oh, I'm You're coming to me. Eat you.
Okay, let me skip this. So, let me pause here. So, we have here an Avengers game. Oh no. A Sports Connection, Rabbit's Land, which is another game that I'm interested on getting, Just Dance 4, Assassin's Creed 3, which I had for a moment and the game glitched, so I just sold it because it was so boring. Your Shape, it's another game that I see constantly in clearance. And Rayman Legends, which there was a big controversy about that game because they delayed the game for a year instead of releasing it on Wii U, because they wanted to release it on other systems. And even the employees that developed the game were like, no, I don't agree to this. But Rabbit's Land, I'm interested. Oh no, let me skip this. I don't want to see people in my video game thing. We'll see people? Yeah, more people. And Marvel. I don't remember this Marvel game. Well, why was I motivated for this E3? I don't remember. Now that I'm watching this, this is not that good. So Nintendo Land. This is an excellent game, but sadly, this is one of the worst trailers ever. Well, presentation, actually. But this developer actually explain the things really well, but it's hard to explain something without the audience looking at it. So it gives me this impression that they didn't have a trailer for this. And also, just looking at the graphics, people were like, oh no, another toys thing.
I hope you will try it on the show floor to see how it has progressed.
But the game looks fine.
There were three objectives. Playing games all
well, not that fine, but it looks fine.
As for what role Miiverse will fulfill in Nintendo Land, I'd like to talk about that in detail during tonight's developers roundtable.
Wow, early Nintendo Land.
And those of you watching online on Nintendo All Access, you may have a chance to see what it will
be. You have Luigi's Ghost Mansion. I actually really like this game. When we play Nintendo Land the home, I always ask for Luigi's Ghost Mansion, and I ask so much that now people ask me to play this game. Because it's very fun. Oh, the ghost has attacked one of the humans. There are a few things that you can do here. That's Ridley, by the way. There are a few things that you can do in this overworld that are very fine. And also, this reminds me a lot of Disney Infinity for some reason. Where there is a plaza also. Well, but the part of the plaza is not very interesting. What I like here, though, is the jukebox. But the minigames are what it is at. And there are lots of options in the minigames. You can use the Wiimote when someone else is playing in the gamepad or doing anything, something else. You can just use the Wiimote. So people complained that this E3 was only fireworks, like minutes of fireworks. But it's literally 1 minute. Well, a little more, but still. Why did people get mad about this? This was literally the end of the show. You can just leave. Also, they are using the colors or something. It was still lame. I say that, but see that? It was so short. Well, that was the presentation. So what we got? Pikmin 3. Explanation about the Wii U or something, New Super Mario Bros. U, Zombi U, Scribblenauts, because I remember I had in my head 5 games that I really wanted to play for this system, and that was the reason why I actually wanted the Wii U. And Lego City, probably. I already said Pikmin 3, Nintendo Land, Lego City, New Super Mario Bros. U, and probably Scribblenauts, if it's not Zombi U. So I was very hyped about this system because it presented just the barely amount that I wanted, that it was 5 games. So that's it from me. Good day, good care, and goodbye.